What's cool? That's his ice.
Gary, icy nips.
Representing BG Copeland. Bad Boys from Bowling Green, Kentucky, Dalton Wild Boy Coleman.
The BG Bad Boys, Dalton Coleman. 0-1, and made his debut back at Hardrock MMA 79 in April. Lost via submission in 55 seconds. Looking to pick up his first win. This is a welterweight bout here. Coleman, 22 years old, 6 foot tall.
They wrote this song about him?
I think this is about him, yeah.
Introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, weighing in at 166 pounds, representing HICS.
Todd Neal just
MMA.
Confirmed that was an elbow in the
also
last fight
Bowling Green, Kentucky,
on the disqualification.
Dee Bloodworth.
And it was also right in front of the commission as well. So, I mean, if you're going to throw an elbow in an amateur fight, don't do it right in front of Todd Neal. That guy doesn't miss anything.
No. We've been to a lot of fights, David McKinney, all across this great land. We still haven't come close to the events Todd Neal attended.
That's right. Dee Bloodworth here, representing HICS.
High-intensity combat under the tutelage of Donnie Wallace.
His first fight here, 20 years old. Another couple young guys. Looks like Coleman is going to have their height and reach advantage in this bout.
I think they're making Bloodworth clean his nails.
Or cut them. I've seen him make the guys cut their nails before as well. They both have the reach advantage over Gary Copeland, though. Just throwing that out there.
Because those pecs are so big.
Yeah. He has an 87-inch reach, though. From a wingspan, fingertip to fingertip.
We're normally blessed with the best seats in the house as we look here, just looking at the sea of people. We've got a barbecue going on outside. You don't get to see this very often.
It's a great atmosphere for some local MMA.
$2 Miller Lights, come on. Kel, our beautiful ring girl.
Set to go here. Dalton Coleman in the red and black. Dee Bloodworth in the black.
They both got their hands up early.
They're ready to go. I don't think they're going to be landing punches from this far. They're not in range yet.
Touch of gloves. Here we go. Coleman tries to tee off early.
Bloodworth looking for the takedown. Coleman trying to grab the neck. Has that wizard on the right side, does Coleman. That's one of the techniques where recently in MMA, fighters are really learning how to use the whizzer. Guys that want to stay on their feet are able to finally stay on their feet. Some nice punches from Bloodworth. He grabs the cage.
Get the warning from Gary Copeland.
There's a knee from Bloodworth. Now Coleman drops to his knees. Some big shots. Bloodworth has a front headlock position. Someone's bleeding.
Can't tell who's
bleeding.
Not sure.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that's Bloodworth or Coleman punching him right in the back of the head. Right in front of the ref as Coleman's mouthpiece came out.
they stopped the action themselves.
And Bloodworth now taking the back of Coleman. Locking in the rear naked choke, and that's it. Great performance there by Dee Bloodworth. And I think that might be his own blood.
Donnie Wallace looks a little upset at the fight. Yeah, that they did stop the fight themselves. Looks like we got an angry mother here, staring one of the opponents down.
Yeah.
You said you hadn't seen anything crazy happen yet. This could be your night.
The very first round, your winner by rear naked choke, Dee Bloodworth.
Dee Bloodworth now 1-8.